way to meet with a group who call themselves the Cave Clan. They've agreed to take me out with them on an expo. That is, we'll be exploring parts of Melbourne City underground. Underground. Underground.
This is called the Lower Maze, and we'll head through the Lower Maze to the river and then up the waterfall to Upper Maze.
Well, it looks like we're going in. There's the waterfall. Headed into the cave, so I guess we'll follow.
Cave Clan explore drains and what we call cavities. We explore stormwater drains, I should say, and cavities, which is just basically tunnels and chambers and whatnot underground. And they basically explore artificial, man-made cavities. The Cave Clan started in 1986, Australia Day is the official day that we celebrate as the anniversary. It sort of built up during the summer of 85, 86, and it started when we were out at Diamond Creek Mines, which is east of Melbourne, probably 30 or so kilometres, and I was exploring with Woody and Sloth, who were the other two founding members. And we're just up, way up this mine, sort of, half an hour up it. And we just sat down and said, oh, we should do this more often. And we all agreed, we all really enjoyed it. We can be happy underground.
What kind of people join the Cave Clan? Well, it's sort of how long is a piece of string? It's mostly, I guess, you get a lot of younger people.
It's quite a mix of people, really. We've got people who are sort of professionally employed. We've got teachers and scientists. We've got students and unemployed people as well. The new stuff, I think, is quite a major thing for everyone. Particularly, I think there's an element of wanting to find something that can be named after you.
I got motivated to join the Cave Clan through just new interests, something different to try. I'm always trying new things. And I just thought, well, here's something that I haven't done before, and I'll probably do it for the next who knows, a year or maybe two before I get bored of it and I'll move on to another thing.
I remember the first time I went to a drain, I knew nothing about it at all. I had a friend who was into it. She's like, yeah, come to a drain. I'm like, a drain, what's that? Okay. And so I was about 16. I said, okay, then I'll go. And I just had some all these weird ideas like, oh, yeah, you know, there's like all the tunnels are connected and there's a group of weird people that live under the city and eat children and stuff like that. It's not a proper expo till Tequila's injured herself. One time I was in a rail tunnel and we thought we had a train coming, so I've got to get to the Manhive. And we're running, and my friend trips me over, Cherry tripped me over, and we're at the ditch. And there's a ditch maybe this wide and 3 foot deep at the edge of the tracks to get to the Manhive, filled with those big, painful railway stones. I run, crash full force on my knee into that. Full force on my knee onto those stones, fucking cane myself. One kid sadly was killed a couple of years back, but he went in when it was flooding and raining. And in fact, apparently I don't know that much about this because this was kind of before my time. But apparently the ladder he was clinging onto above there, you can get out of the manhole fairly easily. And about 6 months prior to when he drowned, the council concreted it up. And had they not done that, he could have survived.
What's your name?
Ziggy. Z-I-G-I.
Oh, fuck, I nearly fucked that up. I never did that. What's yours?
Greg.
Hi. Boring. Look at that kid.
Brush it down with lots of force. The average level is about here. Up to here, so if you're actually in the drain, it's not going to be the water that kills you, it's going to be smashing into the poles or falling over the water.
They taught me how to make paper.
He just kept going on about the wash, right?
Yeah, I think he was stealing the moment.
Yes. You'd know about that.
Yeah, and also,
sometimes how horrible it is.
There's plastic down there, did you hear about that? We've got to do more expos with burning torches. It's so good.